What do you think of when you hear the words classical music? Some might think music from a long time ago. Others might think pretty music. And still others might think of music that is boring or lasts a long time. Hopefully, some of you think that it is music that is exciting and dramatic, too. Well, we're here to tell you that not all classical music is from a long time ago, and it certainly does not have to be pretty. There are many people still writing music for the instruments of the orchestra. In fact, the art of writing classical music is a living and vibrant art form. Composers today still write symphonies. They also write chamber music, or music for smaller groups of players, which is what we are. Music has changed much since the time of Bach, Mozart, and Beethoven. All art is to some degree a reflection of the time in which it was created. Recent classical music is no different. The last 100 years have seen incredible things, from horrible world wars to amazing new technology. We experience change at an ever-accelerated pace. Composers are affected by these things just like everyone else, and you can hear it in their music. Many composers started to look for new sounds, and that's what this piece is about, to introduce you to a number of these new techniques as we go on a quest for new sounds. First, you will hear a theme or melody played by all the instruments of the ensemble. This melody does not sound like melodies you may be used to hearing. Traditional melodies are easily singable, but this melody is jagged with unpredictable rhythms. It does not imply major or a happy sound. Nor does it imply minor or a sad sound. It does not make one note home base. Move away from that note. Instead, it uses all 12 notes equally. This kind of melody is called a row. A variation of the row can be heard in the cello. The row is associated with a technique called serialism, and a composer named Arnold Schoenberg pioneered this technique in the 20s. Once a composer has created a row, they use traditional techniques to help expand their musical ideas. One technique is inversion, or to flip the music upside down. Let's hear our row upside down. Another technique is retrograde, or to play the notes backwards. Let's hear that as well. Not all composers use serialism. Some composers began to look outside of classical music to the world of visual art. What you are hearing right now is musical pointillism, an idea borrowed from a painter named George Seurat. In painting, pointillism uses very small dots combined to make shapes. Musical pointillism does the same thing, but with sound. Composers also started to look for ways to use traditional instruments but make brand new sounds with what are called extended technique. In this next session, many of our performers will play solos involving extended techniques. Thank you. The last century was witness to amazing new technology. The invention of the computer has had an effect on every aspect of our lives, including music. Composers began to experiment with sounds created electronically. Some composers even consider the laptop itself an instrument. Here is a small duet between singer and laptop.
Thank you.